guys, Miss Richo here. Today what we're going to do is just go through an Anvil basic on lesson two. You can see on the screen here, this is an example of what we're going to do. So please enter your name, enter your age. The user would enter their name and their age. Then there's an added button to generate a message. The message would come out over here. Okay, so to do that, if you look on your slide in lesson two for Anvil Basics, you'll see on page 23 all the design aspects and what you should name all of your properties and elements here. Okay, so let's get started. New blank app, interior design. First, you need to name it up here. String and concatenation. What we'll do is go into here. You need to get a label over here. Pop it in there. Pop in the text here, string concatenation, like so. Okay, so we need all three labels along here, and we've got our little text boxes in here, and then you can see there's a button, BTN button, and a label there. So we're just going to pop these in. So to do that, start off with self label, the name label. So we go up to here, you've got your labels here. If you're not sure what to name it, again, click on here. Just double check it, self.label_name. We just put it in here. self.lbl_name. Enter your name here, and we want to enter your age. Another label up here, self.label_age, self.label_age. Now just remember, this is so important that you don't get any of these wrong, okay, because it won't work. It'll be an error. All right, so again, please enter your age. Now we've got a text box here. When you scroll over here, you'll have text box come up, just like button. So that'll come in handy later, but text box, you want to click and drag into here to name it. Let's make sure we get the right one. self.text_name. So again, self.text_name. Don't have to put any text because that's what the user is going to put in. And then the second one is self.text_age. So again, grab your box over here. self.text_age. Okay, like so. Enter. Now the next part is your button. So we want to generate a button here. I'm going to go with the highlighted button here. So I click and drag it there. You can see it's got the blue color. So we need a nice orange there like that. In here, all right, like so. The most important part is, again, making sure that you've named it correctly. So if you have a look at here, you want self.button_message, self.btn_message. So that's important. And then down the bottom, you've got your text with generate message. Right down the bottom is the most important part, is that clicking on the button, okay? Because that there generates this text in here. We go over to here, we grab a label, pop it in here, and we need another label over here. We need to name that label. So again, if you're not sure, use this self.label_message .lbl_, and it's got msg, and then we want to label that with text, so message will appear. And then in here, we just go into self.label_message, like so. Now the next part of our slides, once you've done all of the labels, double check that you've done that correct. But most of all, this is really important in the events section, is that you've got to have the btn_generate.message_message_click. And the reason that is that once you have done that, when you click on that, is in the events, you click on here, and that actually writes the code for you so that it's ready to go. And then you just press enter here, and then you're going to type in the rest of the code. Now, if you look at the PowerPoint, the code is actually there for you. So you're defining the variables of name and age. So you've got your name and age equals self.text @_name.text. And that, and then message equals name plus. This is where you write the message. So the name, add, always put a space, you are, then a space plus their age, because whatever comes from their age will go into there, and then years old. You pop in that text. This is aligned. And again, you can see from the PowerPoint, you've got the black text in here, all in there like so. And then, so when you go to run it, pop in your name, and your age, and then you generate the message, Richo, comma, you are 21 years old. And if you have a look at your code, so I'm just going to stop that, you can see it's gone Richo, the name that I've inputted. I've also put in a comma and then space you are, and then it's added the age variable that I've put in, and then years old. Okay, and that's literally all we do for this class. Run it. Make sure when you've run it, you publish. Once you've published it, you can copy that link and paste it into your Google Classroom into private comments. So then I can have a look at it. That's literally this class. Play around with it a little bit. The design, I would have made this into boxes like I have in this one here. Check it all out. And that's it for today. That's lesson 2, which is in slide 22 to 27. Okay, and that's it for today. Thanks for listening, guys. See you.